Now let's take a look at the problem of template matching. So imagine you're given a little template, a small little pattern or image of an object, and you want to find this template exactly the way it looks in a larger image. So this is done using a technique called correlation. Let's take a look at how that works. So here is once again the problem. Let's say that this is the image that's given to you and this is the template. You want to find this pattern in this image. How do we locate it? So one way you would do this is essentially slide the template over the image, and at each point you can find the difference between the template and the image in the overlapping region, and you can come up with a metric for that distance, that difference, and wherever that difference is really small, you're going to say you've found the template. So how do we formalize this? We can say what we want to do is to find, minimize the difference between the template and the image. So you take the difference between those two, you square up all of those differences, and then you add them up. So this is called the sum of squared differences. And when that's zero, you know that you've found a part of the image that looks exactly like the template. So now we can expand this. We can expand this out, and what we would get is f squared t squared minus 2ft. Just expanded this out, the square right here. So minimizing this eij is equivalent to maximizing this term right here. So let's take a look at this term. This term is called the cross correlation between f and t, cross correlation. And that's denoted as RTF. And the symbol for it, you know, the symbol for convolution is an asterisk. Symbol for cross correlation is this right here. So you can see, if when you look at this expression right here, you're already seeing that it looks a lot like a convolution. So let's take a look at the two together. Convolution is this expression right here. T convolved with F, or F convolved with T. Cross correlation is this. And the only difference between these two expressions is it's I minus M and J minus N here, whereas it's M minus I and N minus J here. So in other words, in the case of correlation, there is no flip. You take the template, you don't flip it, you just do a product and at each point, and then you sum up the result. So what that says is that correlation is convolution without a flip. Mathematically, that has a lot of implications. However, in terms of implementation, they're very, very similar. So now let's take a look at cross-correlation and a problem that we have to deal with. Imagine, and we'll take the example of a 1D signal. So this is your expression, 2D expression for cross-correlation. And let's say that we look at this 1D example where this is the template given to you, and this is the image that's given to you. Clearly, we want to find the point A. We want to declare A to be the point where the template exists, because this exactly matches this. So guess for a moment what the result is going to be. What is going to be RTF at A, B, and C, and which one is going to be the highest? Well, it turns out that the cross correlation is going to be the highest at C. And then the next highest is going to be B, and finally the desired output A. Why is that? And that's because these values here in C and B are much larger than the values that you have within A. And therefore, even though T doesn't match these two signals in terms of the pattern itself, the final result of the cross correlation is going to be highest for this, next highest for this, and the least for this. And that's definitely not the result we're looking for. So this is a problem with cross correlation which we need to fix. And we do that by normalizing the cross correlation. So here you see the same expression for the cross correlation, but you're going to divide it this time by these two terms. And this corresponds to the energy in the image, in the area of the image that overlaps with the template. That's what this is. And this is the energy of the template itself. So by doing this, you make the correlation, cross-correlation, insensitive to changes in brightness. So let's say you had a template that you captured, a pattern that you captured with the camera at some point. It was taken under some lighting conditions and camera gain and so on. And then this pattern appears exactly in its true form, except under different lighting condition, different camera gain in a scene. It doesn't matter, using this normalized correlation, you can find it to be an exact match in the image. So now, coming back to our example that we were looking at, here's your template, and here is the signal, the image that we were looking at. And you find now that the normalized correlation for A is greater than for B, which is greater than that of C, which is exactly what we want. So let's take a look at how this works in a real image and a real template. Here's the template we started off with in the beginning. Here's your image. And you find here, if you look closely, that the brightest point in this cross-correlation, normalized cross-correlation map is this point right here, which is exactly where the template lies, where the template should match the image.